This Wednesday on AEW Dynamite, two surprise entrants will be revealed for the Owen Hart Foundation tournament. Billed as the Joker entrants, one mystery opponent will appear in the men's bracket and one in the female side of things. For today's video, we'll be looking at the men's tournament with the mystery man set to fight reigning ROH television champion Samoa Joe for a place in the semi-finals of the cup. So in today's video, let's look at 10 candidates to fill the spot as we discuss who could be the surprise entrant in the men's Owen Hart Foundation tournament. And before we get into it, why not drop a like on the video to give the YouTube algorithm a kick, and let me know in the comments below who you think the Joker will be. Super bad Kip Sabian has been missing from AEW television ever since Miro wrecked him on an episode of Dynamite in April 2021. After going their separate ways, Miro has gone on to have the run of his life, whereas Kip remained off TV to undergo shoulder surgery. However, he has recently been showing up at AEW events with a cardboard box on his head, suggesting he has undergone a gimmick change. Whilst an appearance from Sabian wouldn't be the most prestigious of possibilities for the Owen, his return seems imminent, given the time that he's been lurking around with his new persona, although a departure from the company due to a contract expiration also seems just as likely. If it were to be Kip taking on Samoa Joe this Wednesday, the Samoan submission machine would be expected to make quick work of the young Brit, making his role as the Joker the most unlikely on the list. One of the biggest stars in the history of New Japan's junior heavyweight division, Kushida had an impressive run with the company. He is a two-time Best of the Super Junior Tournament winner and a six-time IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion. Most recently, he was a member of WWE's NXT roster before leaving the company in April 2020 after his contract expired. Much like Owen, his moveset incorporates a lot of submission holds and is also a good high flyer who can get the crowd up on their feet. Moreover, Owen Hart was also a junior heavyweight for New Japan in the 90s, and it would be fitting for the man dubbed as the ace of the junior heavyweights to pay tribute to him. With his contract having ended rather than him being released, he is not subject to a non-compete clause, and whilst Kushida is reportedly New Japan bound, AEW's working relationship makes an appearance a possibility. Johnny Gargano was one of the most successful stars of the NXT brand. A former NXT champion, NXT tag champion, and three-time NXT North American champion, Johnny was the first ever wrestler to become an NXT Triple Crown champion. He is notable for his heated rivalry with former teammate Tommaso Ciampa, although he had several other fondly remembered matches on the black and gold brand. Johnny's skills are undeniable, becoming one of the pillars of NXT before its recent rebrand, with him a favorite of the internet wrestling community. He has made a name for himself and has a huge fan base, and an appearance from Gargano would be a crowd pleaser indeed. Johnny left WWE at the end of 2021, and since then his wife and fellow wrestler Candice LeRae has given birth to their first child, and both have remained out of the business until now. Perhaps this Wednesday could be the time for Johnny Wrestling to come back to wrestling. Current ROH World Champion Jonathan Gresham has made a name for himself in the business as one of the greats of the technical game. Most wrestlers who are 5'4" will find it hard, if not impossible, to become a major star in wrestling, but Gresham has mastered his craft and made it look easy. Often called the best technical wrestler on the planet, Gresham has incorporated this into his gimmick, adopting Ring of Honor's pure style of wrestling, making it his own. He is a submission specialist, and this coupled with his knowledge of various pinning combinations has led him to be given the title of the Octopus. A technician of his caliber would be a suitable choice to honor Owen Hart. Being the top face of ROH, Gresham has already wrestled on AEW television, having defended his ROH world title at Battle of the Belts earlier this year. As well as this, although he is part of the ROH brand, he is officially signed to All Elite Wrestling as he carries the ROH torch into a new era. God's favorite champion, Miro, hasn't been featured on AEW television since losing to Bryan Danielson at Full Gear 2021, with him said to be working through an injury at the time. This was off the back of a dominant TNT title run, with him being booked as a monster heel. Although he doesn't have any relations with Owen Hart, and his brute style is nothing like Owen, including him as the Joker does make sense. It would be a great way for him to return, battling one of the business's best big men in the form of Samoa Joe, and it would no doubt be a for fans of heavyweight wrestling. Despite prior injuries, Miro is said to be ready to go, and his return is imminent, with the Owen providing a big platform for the Bulgarian to return to All Elite Wrestling. Davey Boy Smith Jr. is the son of the late Davey Boy Smith, popularly known as the British Bulldog. Davey has wrestled for numerous promotions over the years, starting his career in WWE where he was a one-time tag champion before being released in 2011. Since then, he has wrestled for companies such as NWA, MLW, and New Japan Pro-Wrestling before a brief return to WWE in 2020. However, he never got a chance to wrestle on television and was released shortly after. As the son of Diana Hart, Davey is the nephew of both Bret and Owen Hart, and he's been training to be a wrestler since a very young age. Understandably enough, his moveset is heavily influenced by his father and uncles, with moves like the Running Power Slam and Sharpshooter paying homage to his relatives. Being a member of the Hart family, it would make a lot of sense if he were part of the tournament. It would be a great way to introduce him to the AEW fans and allowing the Hart family to participate in a tribute to their loved one, with a win over the reigning ROH television champion a great way to debut. Wyndham, famously known as Bray Wyatt in WWE, was one of the most over talents in the company in recent memory. Although he started his career as the baseless Husky Harris, he underwent an evolution to become Bray Wyatt, a cult leader with a wonderful way with words. Later on, he would transform into a children's television personality seeking forgiveness before unveiling the Fiend, his true inner darkness. Wyndham has been praised for his creativity, and it's quite likely that if he does return to pro wrestling, he will do so with a new character, leaving fans eager to see what he comes up with next. Perhaps a quick victory over fellow big man Samoa Joe would be the perfect way to make an impact. With that said, an appearance from Wyndham seems like it would be better served with more hype and build, perhaps through a series of vignettes before his ultimate arrival. Perhaps a spot in the Owen isn't optimal, but it would be pretty cool nonetheless. The best bout machine, Kenny Omega, has been on hiatus ever since he lost his AEW World Championship to Hangman Page at Full Gear last year. It's since been revealed that he has been working through several injuries in recent years, having put his body under too much pressure before deciding to take a much needed break. Kenny is regarded by many as the best wrestler in the world, and a spot in the Owen Hart tournament could be a fun way for him to pay tribute to a fellow Canadian. Whilst his return schedule is a mystery, AEW is said to be aiming for a comeback at some point in 2022. Perhaps a return in the Owen could set up an inevitable match against the head of the undisputed Elite, Adam Cole, in the final, with a civil war expected within the Elite ranks. A return for Omega does seem unlikely so soon, but it certainly can't be ruled out. Cesaro left WWE when his contract expired in February 2022 after 11 years with the company. During that time, he shockingly won just one singles title, the United States Championship. For years, fans have voiced their discontent at how Cesaro was being underutilized and is often regarded as one of the most underrated wrestlers in the company. Cesaro's style of wrestling is not too different from Owen's, with both of them being known for being great technical wrestlers. On top of this, Cesaro has the necessary strength and physique to believably defeat Samoa Joe and win the whole tournament. He is also a former tag team partner and close friends with Tyson Kidd, somebody who has close ties with the Hart family. Since leaving WWE, Cesaro has not signed with any other promotion and has been quiet about his future, with him said to have rejected all approaches. With AEW president Tony Khan having recently bought out Ring of Honor, many have suggested Cesaro could show up on either brand, with him being a former ROH tag team champion. An appearance as the Joker in the Owen would be a great way to reintroduce him to fans, with a win over Joe setting up a television title shot somewhere down the line. Bullet Club have once again been making waves around the pro wrestling world recently, with leader Jay White at the center of it. Recently, New Japan and AEW announced their first ever joint pay-per-view, The Forbidden Door, and it's only logical to think that Bullet Club will be a big part of it, with Jay White being on AEW TV for the announcement. White is a solid in-ring talent and has been complimented for his great psychology, and a wrestler of his caliber would be a great addition to the Owen and would add to the prestige of the cup. Although the two stables seem to be on the same page for now, a clash between Bullet Club and a branch of the Elite seems inevitable considering the history between the two groups. White recently name-dropped the Undisputed Elite as allies, although that could very quickly change. It would make sense then for Jay to be the Joker in the Owen, going on to face Adam Cole in the final at Double or Nothing, kickstarting a feud that could be paid off at the Forbidden Door later this year. But what do you think of these 10 entrants, and who do you think the Joker will be? Let me know in the comments down below. And make sure you check out 10 candidates for the women's side of things, and if it hasn't been uploaded yet, there will be another list for you to check out.